This short video is going to go through the property search tab. First thing we're going to do is log into our account, obviously, at recallcheck.com. And over to the left, you're going to see a property type drop down at the top. There's many different things that you can search on here. And you know, for the most purpose, you're going to search between mostly any and recall check. And I'm going to kind of get into the difference of this recall check. So the reason why you may want to search recall check, I'm just going to pull up a client here. So I'm just looking at a few sample properties. And when you're searching by recall check as the property type, the options link over to the far side will actually allow you to view the recall check report. If you're searching by any of the other drop-down options, you will not be able to open up the RecallChek report or the RecallTrack email. So you do need to be searching by that RecallChek service if this is something that you're going to be searching by. If you search any and you search the same criteria, you will find pretty much the same properties. If there is a property in the system that was already submitted and you need to make a change, you can simply click the link to the left under viewer edit, and you can come in here and you can change the information. So maybe the client's last name was spelled wrong, or maybe the email address was different and they requested another one, or whatever the case is. Maybe there's appliances that you need to update. You can see this is a test property that we put in, but you know, maybe you needed to have, you know, the stove wasn't a Whirlpool anymore. It was actually GE and the model number was, you know, XYZ789 or whatever the case is. If you need to make any changes, you can do so here. And then you can also save that change by clicking the update property button below. This is a great thing to know. Also, you can come over here and under options, doesn't matter which property type you're searching by, but you can always view the email events. And by viewing the email events, it'll show you all the emails that have been sent out to this property, at what period, who it was sent to. So you can see that the recipient was mdor@recallcheck.com. And this is to the company account that's on this test account of ours. And we see the date that it was sent out and the outcome. If there was an actual link in here for, like, maybe you have your account set up for the warranty email to be emailed to the buyer, there will be a view link here. And this is the case where you'd have to actually view the recall check report from what we were speaking about just a few minutes ago. If there was an email to the client, to agents or anything like that, you can view everything under these email events. So you can access this at any time in your account. The recall check app is not a place to edit information. The app is only used to submit the appliance data to us from the inspection. So if you forgot to add an appliance, or you know, you need to make a change after you submitted it from the app, you would actually have to come here into the website and make the changes here. So if you have any questions, don't hesitate to call us, 888-854-0798.